That's how I manage and balance. Please keep criticizing. I got paid 5,000 for that arrest, remember? People really were like, who's this girl? And I was actually picked up from the college canteen when I was bunking my classes. I think it was pretty simple. Let's get started. Yeah, I was bunking. Hey guys, this is Sunayana Fozdar and I'm chatting up with the voice of women today. I was always a nautanki child, you know. When I was in the fourth standard, I did this television show, Khulja Simpson. It was a kids' show with Lakshmikant Berde ji. So I think that's where the filmy kida already bit me. And then when I came back to college, I was casted for an ad for Chevrolet cars. That ad really became a hit. And one thing led to another after the Chevrolet ad, but that's how I started. That way, I'm really lucky. Get two families that are so supportive. Like they say, behind every successful man, there's a woman. I think behind every successful woman, there is a team of women. There is an army of women. Behind my success is my mom, my sister, my mother-in-law, and not to forget my husband, my father-in-law, all of them who support me day in and day out so that I can go back there outside and work. But I think it eventually boils down to whether you like what you do, and then I think you'll find your way out to do it anyway. And I don't feel like I'm going to work. I love what I do, so I think it's my life. I can't imagine being without it. Not a fitness freak, but yes, I try to eat healthy. I try to have small meals in a day. I'm not really into gymming or hardcore workout as such, but I dance to keep myself fit. I probably go on a jog, on a walk there. So nothing too hectic, something that I can manage forever, because I'm not into diets and fads and all of that. But there are days where I have my chocolate cakes and my chocolate and all of that. But I try to not overeat, you know, I try to keep a balance there. But yeah, something that I can go on with my regular life as well. Like, I don't make any special arrangements to have any diet. So yeah. Criticism is not just outside, but I have a lot of critics at home as well. My mother being the biggest. I think this is what I chose, right? This is what we choose as actors. We want to be constantly, appreciated, or we want to be popular, we want to be known. Then why would you be an actor if you don't want to be scrutinized or recognized? Or, you know, scrutiny, yes. Sometimes it does get a little intrusive, but I think that there's if you like the good, you have to embrace the bad as well. Whereas criticism is concerned, I think if I wouldn't get criticism, I wouldn't grow from what I have, in the past few years. It constantly helps me to become a better actor. In fact, I like to see what people have to say about my work. It's for the good, it's for your growth. If you are in self-isolation without any criticism, how will you grow? How will you grow as a person, as an actor? So yeah, I'm totally game for at least y'all are watching. That means at least y'all are noticing and appreciating too. Yeah, a lot of people came up with, oh, you dance. Well, I've always been dancing. I started in my early days. I started with this video, which was Gori Hai Kalaiya by Bappi Lahiri, which was really famous back then. It was a remix video. And I used to do a lot of shows, a lot of dance shows, which took a backseat when I was focusing on acting and television. You know, this lockdown has given me a lot of time to, I can say, maybe rediscover that passion and realize how much it makes me happy, and I should do it more often. So yeah, I am passionate about dance. I am. So, guys, on a serious note, I do not do a lot of facials. I don't touch my skin a lot. I have a lot of water. I feel it clears out all the toxins, and I say this 100 times, but guys, having water really helps. And yeah, I moisturize my skin. So that, you know, to avoid lines and fine lines and to avoid dryness, moisturize, water. And yeah, I remove my makeup every single time before going to bed. Your skin has to sleep and breathe too. Trust me, these are the things that I swear by, and I do nothing much. And then be happy. I think the more that you feel good and happy, the more that it shows and you feel radiant. And trust me, it works. Like, when you're happy, it shows on your face. So I read this before also, but I read it the other day. It says, why wait for the storm to pass? Dance in the rain while it lasts. You know, I've heard it before, but this really made a lot of sense to me. And with the situation right now, it sort of struck a chord. Why wait for a storm to pass? Why don't we dance in the rain? Let's not wait for something great to happen. Let's make the most of whatever we have right now. One thing that I've truly learned is that do not take the smallest of things for granted. Life is beautiful. You know, when we go out now, the next time I'm going to value things more. I'm going to be a happier person. I've learned a lot of things. A lot of things. And you know, a lot of things that I used to think I can't do without, I think I've proved myself wrong. You know, I'm in the current scenario, I am doing without a lot of things. So I think never say never. Just value every moment you have. Seize the moment and do not take things for granted. Comfortable and chic. So I'm a very comfort dresser. I could live in my pajamas, give interviews in my pajamas. But no, that's where chic comes in the picture. So comfort and chic is my kind of fashion. A lot of these things that I wanted to tell people, I think it came out through the short film. I directed it and executed it. I put it on my Instagram. A lot of people resonated with it. A lot of people told me that it touched their heart. A lot of people said that, you know, some said it gave them goosebumps when they saw the short film. It was about millennial couples. You know, I've seen recently a lot of people, couples especially, facing pressures of living an Instagram life. I see a lot of people comparing their lives with these rosy pictures that you see all over the internet. That, you know, this is how you should be, this is how where you should travel, and these are couple goals. And they end up feeling very unhappy, and they end up, you know, losing their own confidence because of these so-called pictures or, you know, things that they see. Life is about small things. You know, your definition of happily ever after could be different from another person's. You know, why be dependent on someone else for your happiness? I think stay low on your expectations. I see a lot of people who are not exactly happy or complicated when it comes to relationships around me. So I thought this was the best way to share this message, and it did work. I think a lot of people saw it and they, you know, thought about it and they were like, oh, this is what happens with us. And you know, we looked at it in a different way, and now we see it in a different light through this film. I'm glad, even if I can touch one life from it, that's what an entertainer is about. So more short films coming your way. We are constantly looking for approval and for attention elsewhere. But you don't need that approval. Yeah, you know, just be confident, just keep going, be persistent, and love yourself. Never ever let anyone tell you that you won't be able to do it, or you know, this is not meant for you. Because trust me, you can do way more then you can think of also. And if you don't love yourself, no one else is going to love you. So don't look for validation in someone else. I think you have it in you, because only if you love yourself will you be able to give all the love outside. So stay strong, show passion, compassion, not just for people outside but for yourself too. And spread love, happiness and positivity. Bye guys, stay safe. Love you. Take care.